No weapon formed against me shall prosper. It won't work.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I am Pastor Agnes Williams of Agnes Williams Ministries, here to discourse with you again on principles enshrined in the Word of God. Let's pause or pray. Father, we thank you, O God, that you, God, are our refuge in times of trouble. You are our strength when we are weak. And God, today we humble ourselves before you, God. We ask you, O God, to continue to be our refuge and our strength. Continue, O God, to keep us. Let the people of the world know that you are God and you love us, God. Today we thank you, Lord, because you are so great, you are so good. We'll continue to praise you all the days of our lives. In Jesus Christ's name I pray. Amen. Today my topic is the Lord, our refuge in time of trouble. And my scripture is taken from Psalms chapter 9, verse 9. The Lord, our refuge in time of trouble. Psalms 9 verse 9 says, the Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. Who is our refuge? God, not man. The Lord is our refuge in times of trouble. And Psalms 32 verse 7 says, thou art my hiding place, thou shalt preserve me from trouble. Thou shalt compass me about with songs of deliverance, Selah. That was David speaking about God. The world is in troubled times. But today I'm here to give you great encouragement, to give you good news one more time, that the Lord our God is our refuge in times of trouble. No matter what happens, what comes our way, whether it's a hurricane, a storm, whether it's earthquake, whether it's an accident at sea, whether it's an airplane crash, whether it's COVID-19, we must remember that God said in his word that he, the Lord, is our refuge in time of trouble. And what do you mean by a refuge? A refuge is a hiding place. A refuge is a sure and safe place where you are hidden from any untoward or evil thing happening to you, where you are hidden from danger. You know, sometimes one man from a country runs as a refuge to another country because either he's been sought after for a crime he committed, or he's been sought after for something he didn't do, he's been accused of, and he runs to another country for a refuge. Which is a hiding place. A refuge is a hiding place. A refuge is a safe place. And today I want to declare to you that you will not forget that our God is a refuge in times of trouble. He is our hiding place. He is our safe place. And how do we access him? By studying the Word of God and by praying to him, singing praises to him, glorifying his name, because God is worthy of all praise. And even now in the times of deepest trouble, we should not neglect praising God, thanking him every day for the life, thanking him for what has happened, thank him for his strength, thank him for the food, thank him for our government, thank him for our families, thank him for our friends, thank him for the sun, the moon, the stars, thank him for the weather, whether it's bad or inclement. Let us remember that from the beginning of times, God has always been a refuge and a safe place for those who choose to trust in him. Once we trust in Almighty God, he will never, ever make us ashamed or leave us alone. He's our refuge. A refuge in the Bible, in the Word of in the dictionary, is a hiding place. A safe place where nothing bad can happen to you. No evil can catch you there. No enemy can catch you there. You are a refuge. And if God says he's a refuge for the oppressed, yes, we are oppressed right now. The world is oppressed. And it's a time, times of trouble. How can we build up our relationship with God? By studying the Word of God, reading the Word of God, going down our knees or stand up and pray to God in Jesus' name, confess our sins, confess where we have sinned, we are sinners in the hand of an awful God. Every day we live, sin touches us in some way or the other. Confess our sins, repent, ask God to forgive us, and wash us in that blood that Jesus Christ shed, and move on because God forgives us. He says the blood of Jesus Christ shall never lose its power till all of the ransomed church of God are saved to sin no more. So we have a great hope. We have a great commandment. We have a God who loves us with an everlasting love, a love that cannot be measured. Even though you're at home by yourself, with your family, you just continue to seek God's face with your family. You continue to study the Word of God, sing praises to God, read the Psalms, study the Word of God, encourage your family, your children, your husband, your wives, your cousins, your nephews, encourage them to keep trusting God. And each individual person has the liberty and the freedom to approach God in the name of His Son, Jesus Christ, and God will hear and answer. God, our God, Almighty God, is the only faithful God. The gods that are made of stone and you hew them out of silver and gold and iron and brass, they have no life in them. But our God is the only true and living God. Almighty God, Jehovah God, who created the heavens and the earth. This has not been the only crisis or pandemic that the world has seen. And people have come through, people have survived. And those who trust in God, whether they die in the Lord. If they survive serving God. So I want to entreat you all today. Turn to God. God cares about all of us. God loves us with an everlasting love. And when trouble comes, He will never turn His back on His people. When things are going good, mankind turns his back on God. But our God is so loving, so kind, so all-forgiving, that whenever we turn to Him, He does not turn us away. He listens to our prayers, He listens to our cries, and He supports us with the Holy Spirit. He sends angels, He sends people to help us. He makes things better. He pushes back the demonic forces. Our God, who created this heaven and the earth, He said, He is the refuge for the oppressed. Aren't we being oppressed by this COVID-19? Aren't we being oppressed by lack of much more medical care because the doctors are worked out, they are so overworked, the nurses are overworked, the hospitals are overfilled, medicines are finishing. They have not yet really found a cure or antidote for the virus. But if you put your trust in God, you will never fail. If you put your trust in God and you die, you go to be with the Lord. Put your trust in God and He heals you, you will be here to continue to praise God, to announce to the world that our God, the Lord Almighty, is a refuge for the oppressed and a refuge in times of trouble. So today, don't be discouraged. Yes, things are tough. Folks all around you are dying. Folks around you are being tested for COVID-19. You have to be isolated in quarantine, but it's for our good. When there's a plague in the country, you have to do all those kind of things. You have to try to keep away from where the plague emanates. And keep your trust in God. I can assure you that our God is going to bring us through. As He wills, as we trust Him, He will surely bring us through. Because He's our safe place. He's our hiding place. He's our refuge, our strong tower. He is the Almighty God. Where are all the other gods at this time? The gods that they make with stone, and they make with gold and silver, and they beat them and they mold them. Where are those gods? Can they help? Are they helping? No, they have no power. A God that man makes with his hands has no power. Almighty God, who made man, is Almighty God by himself. And if we trust him, by humbling ourselves, repenting of our sins, because at least we were all born in sin. So because we were born in sin, repent of that sin, and then we've sinned along the way, repent of our sins. Accept Jesus Christ, his son who died for us, as the savior of the world, and pledge your life to serve God in spirit and in truth. And start to study the word of God, and you will see what will happen to you. The word of God gives health. It gives life. It gives encouragement. It gives you joy. It supplies riches for you. Once you tune in with Almighty God that you cannot see, but you see God in the other human being. You see God in nature. You see God in people. God's word never fails. Today I want to challenge folks out there. If you don't trust God, try trusting Almighty God. Try giving your life over to God. Read the word of God. Start to sing praises to God. Pray to him in Jesus' name. Pray for your sick family. Pray for your sick relatives. Pray for the people around you who are sick. Pray for our government. Pray for your family. Pray for your enemies. Pray, 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 and give God praise and ask him to have mercy upon us. He said, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and turn from our wicked ways, then he will hear from heaven and he will heal our land. God promises that to mankind. And there are so many promises. If you search the word of God, God over ages and times have given us so many promises. And he is the only true and faithful God. He keeps his word. And if you trust him and you die, you go to a better life. No more sorrow, no more pain, no more sickness, no more COVID, no more coming back here to suffer. Oh, how much God loves mankind. He loves us with an everlasting love. He loves us so much that in his word, he tells us what good things he will do for us if we repent and turn to him and try to live to please him. Love our neighbors, love our enemies. You don't have to keep your enemies near to you to love them. But if you can do good for them, you'll do good for them. But you don't have them in your mind, you hate them and you wish them evil. No, no, no. You forgive your enemies and ask God to give you the strength to do what you have to do for them. Our God, Almighty God Jehovah, is the only awesome God in this world. In this world, in the universe, all over the world, Jehovah God is in control. No matter what man would say, Almighty God, the Father of Jesus Christ, is in control. When we put our trust in him, he becomes our refuge. He becomes our safe place. He becomes our hiding place. He becomes our protector. And even though sometimes we don't serve him, he still protects us. But it is his desire that all should come to repentance and none should perish. So, if I look back in the psalmist says in Psalm 9, he says, I'll praise thee, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will show forth all thy marvelous works. I'll be glad and rejoice in thee. I will sing praise to thy name, O thou most high. During this time of trouble, find some time to sing praises to God. God is a sucker for praises. Find time with your family, with your friends, your husband, your wife, or you alone. Find time to give God praise. And I can assure you, when from a heart of truth you praise God, God's Spirit comes into your life. You feel a difference. You feel strong. You have the assurance that God has accepted your praise and you know that you've been in touch with the Almighty God, and you know that He who made man cares for you and will protect you as long as you seek His face and you stay true to Him and don't turn over to other false gods and serve them. Continue Psalms chapter 9, verse 3, say, when mine enemies are turned back, they shall fall and perish at thy presence. For thou, O God, hast maintained my right and my cause. Thou sattest in the throne judging right. God is the only person, only being who is ultimately the judge of right and wrong. He said, thou hast rebuked the heathen. Thou hast destroyed the wicked. Thou hast put out their name forever and ever. He said, O thou enemy, the destructions are come to a perpetual end. He said, and you have destroyed cities, and their memory will perish with them. He said, but the Lord shall judge, shall endure forever. He has prepared his throne for judgment, and he shall judge the world in righteousness. He shall minister judgment to the people in uprightness. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. So today I want to exhort you. I want to encourage you. Despite what has happened in the past, beside of your non-belief in God, I am encouraging you today to put your trust in Almighty God. You don't need anybody to be with you. You alone in a corner, anywhere. You just go and talk to God and say, Father, I approach you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. I repent of my sins. Forgive me, Lord. And then you can continue asking Him to take away the plague, protect your family, protect your sons, your daughters, your grandchildren, protect your neighbors, your cousins, protect your pastor, protect the government, protect the prime minister, protect your leader in opposition. Protect us all. Because when we are praying, we are to be praying for all people. Even those who dislike you, you pray for them, that God's mercy will be upon them. And when we do that, God is pleased with the offering we give to Him. Our God is the most awesome God. He is the only awesome God. And in Him is a refuge. In Him is a hiding place. In Him is a safe place. And all you have to do, pray to Him in Jesus' name, repent of your sins, and start to read the Word of God. Whatever part of the Bible you want to start to read, and you study the Word of God, find time to sing praises to God, find time to have devotions. Cut off the TV sometimes. Cut off the games. And find time to talk to God. God's ear is always open to hear the cries of mankind. When you cry to Him in sincerity and in truth in Jesus' name, He listens, He hears, and He answers. He sends angels at times to protect us, and we don't even know that. I've had experiences where people came to me at my gate, and they called me, and they told me at two different times, a female and a male, and they gave me some instructions, some advice, be careful, so be careful. And I said, thank you. And when I went into retrospect, and I spoke with two elderly people, they said to me, woman, child of God, God loves you. God sent two angels, a female and a male, at two different times to warn you of what was to come, to warn you of the danger you would have fallen if you did not keep on trusting Him and having your eyes open. And today I thank God that God has proven to be my refuge. When my heart was sorrowful, on the death of my youngest sister, whom I loved. I love all my sisters and brothers. You may not see them around me, but I love them, and they know it. And I thank God that Almighty God still loves us so much that He has proven to be my refuge when I was feeling oppressed. And when the times of trouble came, He was also my refuge. Today I can praise God. I can thank God. I can list how many experiences God has given to me to keep me from the hands of the enemy, to keep me from the oppressors, to show me things that nobody would show me, to show me things that he will just open a portal, a gate, and I will see a whole, like a movie, and I'll see things that people don't believe that I see. But he does those things for me because he knows I will not listen to hearsay and naysay very easily. But sometimes he has to prove to you that this happened. No one knows. I know. The enemy knows. And I'm showing it to you that you will know that I am God, that I'm your refuge. Today I praise God. I want you to find God. You who are listening to me, I want you to find God as your refuge. We are all oppressed at this time. We are oppressed because COVID-19 and coronavirus is all over the world, ravaging people, killing people, making people sick. But our God, Almighty God, who we trust in, who made us, who sent his Son to die for us, he is our refuge. And he's our, when we are oppressed, and he's our refuge in times of trouble. God has made that promise to us. He has made that promise to mankind. It's left to man to turn to God and say, yes, God, I believe your word. You promised to be our refuge, our safe place in times of trouble. So today, God, I come to you. I yield my life to you. I yield my situation to you. I yield the situation with coronavirus to you. I yield it to you, God. Father, you are my refuge. Have your way in my life, in my family's life, in my children's life. Almighty God never fails mankind. He has never failed me yet. He will never fail anybody because he is in control and he does what he sees best and he does what is good for us. Because he loves us with an everlasting love. The Almighty God loves us with an everlasting love. So, don't be discouraged. He says, they that know thy name, O God, will put their trust in thee. For your Lord has not forsaken them that seek you. He says, sing praises to the Lord, which dwelleth in Zion. Declare among the people his doings. Our God is good. Our God loves us. He's our safe place. He's our safe place. He is our refuge. He's our comfort. He's our hiding place. He's the rock of our salvation. Only he alone can give us salvation through his Son, Jesus Christ. So today I want to just say a short prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, you know how the earth is hurting. But God, let all those who seek you prove you to be a God of righteousness and judgment, a God of love. Even those whose hearts are hardened, God, let the Holy Spirit soften their hearts, that they can turn to you, O God, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, and they will find comfort and refuge in you. So today I thank you, God, for being our refuge, for being a refuge and a hiding place for mankind. And I'll praise you all the days of my life. In Jesus' name I pray thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Have a great day. Make God your refuge and your hiding place, and you will never be ashamed or be disappointed. I'm Pastor Agnes Williams, Agnes Williams Ministries. God bless you all. No.